If you're an SEO beginner or you know your website needs optimizing, then this video is for you. Before you start an SEO campaign, you need to know what you're working with. There's no point in creating fantastic content and acquiring backlinks when you've not even got the basics in place. So today, I'm going to show you how to do an SEO audit on your website. Hi, I'm Oliver from Mechanized, and we're a digital agency based in Manchester. At Mechanized, we get extremely good SEO results for our clients. Our clients are now doing 7 figures in sales and ranking very highly for competitive keywords. And it all starts with a manual SEO audit and building a strong foundation for an SEO campaign. As a bonus, I'll leave a link in the description so you can download our SEO audit template so you can start to improve your website. Before I get into it, if you like the video, and if you would like more SEO related videos, hit that subscribe button. Okay, let's get into it. What I love about an SEO audit is that it gives you a chance to find opportunities and not just problems. What you need to do is work through the audit, and then in the end, you'll know exactly what you need to do to lay down a solid foundation. Before I walk you through the audit, you'll need to download the SEO Spider from Screaming Frog. If you've got less than 500 pages on your website, then you'll be able to use the free version. What will also be helpful is a good SEO tool to help you pull website stats. Now we use SEMrush, but you can also use Ahrefs or Moz. If you've not got access to them, then you can just use Ubersuggest, which is free. Okay, so let's take a look at the audit template that we're going to use today. So this is something we've created to suit our needs, and this is what we use for every single SEO audit that we do. As you can see, it's split into various sections, which covers the main areas of SEO. So we've got the website stats, on-page, technical, backlinks, speed, and Google My Business. Now, in the left-hand column, you can see that you got a list of the important items that you need to check. The center column is a brief description of what you're checking, and the third column is where you record your results. So in the website stats section, you simply click on the cell and just enter the number in there to record your result. And all the other sections, we've created a color-coded dropdown with the results already pre-selected. So you've got a choice of non-applicable, pass, and recommended. Okay, so let's take a look at the first section, website stats. So here we've got to look at the authority score, organic traffic, the amount of ranking keywords, referring domains, and total backlinks. So I'll show you how to complete this, and we'll use our own site as an example. So what you need to do is copy your URL, and as I mentioned previously, we like to use SEMrush to get our domain stats. And we'll just search for that. So this gives you some nice stats about your website. So what we need to do is just go to our audit. So we've got authority score, which is 38. Organic traffic, 237. Amount of ranking keywords, 269. Referring domains, that is 444. And total backlinks is 7,700. Okay, so let's move on to the on-page section. Now, this is where it gets a little bit more technical, but it's still quite easy to do. So let's just reset that. So first off is you need to use the SEO Spider tool to crawl your site. So beforehand, if you download the Screaming Frog SEO Spider tool, and that is from here, screamingfrog.co.uk, and you got the free version, which will do nicely if you've got under 500 pages. So all you need to do is just get your URL and copy it into there and hit start. Now this will start crawling your website and you'll get tons of data about your website. It's best to keep in mind that when you're doing the audit, you want to generalize the data. So for example, if there are a few pages without meta titles and description, I'd still mark that down as recommended because you need to optimize them all anyway. So the data for the items you need to check, it either comes from this SEO tool or it's more of a visual check that you just look on your own website as well. So if I give you an example, we'll go through the meta title on our website and the meta description as well. So if you go to the SEO Spider, so what you want to do is change this all to HTML. And then you can see all the different pages here. Let's just make this a little bit bigger. Okay, so if we click on page titles, so you've got your URLs here, and these are your meta titles here. So as you can see, you can scroll down and see them all. And if there's any missing, or if there's any that are too long, or they don't look like they include your target keyword, then you want to mark it down as recommended. But if it looks pretty okay, then I'd mark it down as a pass. So we'll put pass on this. For the meta description, you just click on the meta description tab, and we've got the same thing here. So there, and it gives you the length as well, the length and the pixel width as well, which is quite important. So you can see that you've got descriptions for other pages as well. So I'd also mark that down as a pass. So what's good to know is that, so if we click into the first page, our home page, and then you go to SERP snippet at the bottom, so you can get a visualization of what it'll actually look like in Google, which is quite good. And this is where you can start to play around and see what fits. Okay, so let's give you another example. So if we go back to the audit, let's have a look at navigation. So the navigation is more of a visual check. So what we're looking for is that the navigation needs to be clear, uncluttered, and structured, with the most important pages listed first. So let's go to our website. And so we've got home, our services pages, with all the services underneath. We've got our proven track record, which is our case studies. We've got work, articles, contact. So everything is nice and clean. It's easy to see. It's not confusing. It's quite straightforward. So we'll mark that down as a pass. So navigation pass. Okay, so let's move on to the technical section. So again, I'll do a couple for you. So let's start with the robots.txt. So we need to make sure that it exists and that it's not blocking any of our important pages, like our homepage, service page, contact page. So what you need to do is go to the SEO Spider tool. We'll go to response codes and click on all and blocks by robots. So you want to make sure that your homepage and your important pages aren't listed here. This looks like that's fine. So that's okay. So let's go back to our audit and mark that down as okay. So let's see if there's any 400 and 500 errors. So again, under response codes, we've got this drop down, and we'll just click on client error 400. Okay, so you can see here that there's a couple of errors. This looks like they're external links, not actual pages on our website. So that isn't too bad now, but I will fix that in a minute. So let's mark that down as recommended. Oh, also you've got 500 errors, so you can check that just there. So there's no server errors, so everything's fine, which is good. So that's marked as recommended still. Okay, so then just work your way through all the other items on the list. So things like XML sitemap submitted in your Google Search Console, you'll know that if you've got a Google Search Console, or if you're doing this for a client, I'd mark that down as recommended, just because sometimes they don't always have it done. Things like mobile friendly, that's visual, so you can see that straight away, just have a look on your mobile device. Google Analytics, again, if it's your own site, you should know if you've got Google Analytics set up, or if it's your clients, just ask them. E-commerce conversions, so in our case it's non-applicable because we're not an e-commerce site, and HTTPS, just take a look at your website and you can see that you've got a secure connection straight away, so we'll mark that as recommended. Okay, so next let's take a look at the backlink section. So the first one, just generally backlinks, you can get this from your SEO tool. So in the SEMrush, we've got 7,700 backlinks and 444 referring domains. Now, what you want to do is a little bit of competitor analysis, and you want to see how you measure up against your competitor in this area. Usually, you are going to need more backlinks. So I would mark that down as recommended. Also for the disavow backlinks and the backlink profile, you're not actually going to know this until you get stuck in and start analysing what kind of anchor text you've got. So I'd also mark that down as recommended. Even though we're just defaulting to recommended, it's something that needs to be done. So it is just acting as a checklist at the moment. As for disavow backlinks, that's the same. I put that down as recommended. The majority of people aren't going to have to be disavowing backlinks. It can get very messy if you start messing around with disavow files. So I generally stay away from it. But if you can see that, you know, there is a massive dip in traffic, or if you've been hit by a negative SEO campaign and there's like thousands of just really crappy links, then I'd probably look into disavowing backlinks. The last one, local citations. So you want to make sure that the local citations across the internet is correct. So it mentions your name, phone number, address, and they're all identical to the one on your website. So places you need to go to is places like Google My Business, Yelp, local directories, and Facebook. Okay, so next let's take a look at the speed section. Now, to measure your speed, what we need to do is go to gtmetrics.com, and this is a really good page speed analyzer. So what you need to do is just copy paste your URL into there, go to analysis options and select the location closest to you, and use a realistic broadband connection. So I'm going to use this one, and let's just analyze. And what this is going to do, it's going to give you a list of everything that needs looking at, pass and fails, recommendations. Don't get too hung up about this because you're not going to get 100%. If you're using Google Fonts, Google Analytics, Google Maps, third-party widgets like reviews and chat windows, you're not going to be able to cache everything. So you just need to get it as good as possible. Okay, so once it's done, you'll get a grade and some performance stats like this. It'll show you what's going on with your website. So you have your summary, performance, structure, got your waterfall so you can see when things are actually loading in, what times. So let's just go back to the summary. So these are the main things that have been highlighted. So if we go back to our audit, the main thing is, so they got the page load speed. So, you know, it is a bit on the slower side. You know, it's kind of modern web design for you. You have big, beautiful images, but there are places that you can make savings. So like for ours, the image size is a couple of the things we need to work on. So what we'd do is we put that down as recommended. So as for gzip compression, browser caching, minification, if these show up here, then that means that they've not been implemented. So that's something to look out for. I'm not going to go through it now, but these are the reasons why they're important, and it can give you a bit of extra speed. Okay, so just to complete this section, we do have gzip, so about that's passed. We have browser caching, we have minification, and I know that we don't use a CDN, so I'm going to mark that down as recommended. Okay, so the final part is Google My Business. So the first thing to do is to check that your profile exists. So simply just type in your business name and where you are, and you'll see your Google My Business profile appear. Now, if you've not done this before, then Google automatically creates you one, and then you can just click on Own This Business and then go through the process of owning it. If you're super brand new and there's absolutely nothing there, then just go through the process of creating one. I have done another video on this. I'll leave a link in the description so you can go to that. Okay, so let's have a look at the audit. So you want to make sure your profile exists, check. You want to make sure that your business details are exactly the same as the website. So we've got our address there, got the phone number, added our opening hours as well. So we'll check that. Get some reviews. Reviews are really important for Google My Business. So make sure you ask your customers to leave some reviews. And then what you want to do is you want to add at least three photos in each section. This is just to complete the Google My Business profile a bit more, just to optimize it for local search. So I'd mark all them down as recommendation, because most people don't have them all in. Okay, so when you've completed your whole audit, you should have a nice checklist of what needs looking at. Then it's just a case of setting some time aside and then just working through it. And then at the end, you can re-audit your website using the same template, and then hopefully all your recommendations will turn to passes. So that concludes today's video. So if you want to start increasing your website traffic and ranking better, make sure that you audit your website, find your opportunities and optimize. If you've got any questions, please leave them in the comments below and I'll make sure that I answer them all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.